this is something that we have to give this impression to the students that we are teachers, okay, but we are also students. So you are a junior scholar, I'm a senior scholar. Because nobody wants to have a say on the stage. Okay? Nobody wants to have a say on the stage. Everybody? Or say, people can afford, or can say give it, the guide by the side. So we have to be guided by the side instead say on the stage. So I request you all, whether say some formal or say informal, studies must be on. And that should be visible. Visible to the students. Time to time, you have to tell, oh, tomorrow I have to go for exam. Hey, madam is also going for exam. What exam, madam? I'm doing my MA or this or that. So in this way, they are going to relate themselves with you. That yes, I'm a student, to the student. So we are all from one community. So this will, you know, bring students to you nearer. Then say, understanding and using language. You have given some concept. The child has listened and understanding, internalization. You know, internalization, how we can do it better, that we will be talking about, say, some other things, preventions and remedies. Then come to receive, process, recall, communicate. It happens. You give some information. That information is received. Then it is processed. Then it is, at the time of recalling, it is recalled. And then it is communicated. Whether verbal or in writing. You see, teachers don't give you marks for what you know. Teacher gives you mark what you write. You write in exam. Okay? Or you tell. If there's verbal exam, tell. So your knowledge is good. But apart from knowledge, you must have that kind of communication skills in hand. So you could express yourself effectively. Okay? Then we say, some students have some problem. Actually, this is the characteristics of human being. Now you will realize that we are also part of that. How? Reading and spelling. Dyslexia. What do we call it? Dyslexia. Have you heard of this word?
Yes.
Ah, kare zameen pe rakhe. Good. So dyslexia is there. Then writing. Dysgraphia. What do we call it?
Dysgraphia.
Because say, they can read, spelling is also fine, but some of their writing is not good. So dysgraphia. And then maths. Maths teacher sitting here. Raise your hands. Okay, tough subject. So dyscalculia. What is this? Dyscalculia. So this is the, and then here, auditory processing, listening, visual processing. You know, when we give some concepts, when we give some basics, fundamentals. So the processing takes place. We're talking about the process. So auditory processing. Students speak, say tables. They recite. So processing is going on. That's the processing. Visual. Sometimes we show some pictures. Sometimes we give some diagrams. Okay, so visual. That is appealing visual. I'm giving you lecture. But apart from lecture, I'm showing you some visuals. So now your two senses are involved. No? How many senses do we have?
Five.
Sure? There's the sixth sense I also heard about. Sixth sense. What is the sixth sense? Abhay.
Intuition.
Intuition.
Sixth sense. Sixth sense. Sixth sense, sir. Six sense? Common sense. Abhi common sense bhi to hoti hai bachche. Get the common sense. Right? The seventh one? Seventh one? Ah, wo pata thi. Who said? Yes, 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 yes. Very nice. So this common sense when we talk about, we generally don't like to talk about common sense, because common sense, we are also part of that. But nonsense? Nonsense. No, because the finger is going there. So that's fine. The purpose of education, see, sense is God given. God gives. What will make a child to listen? God has given the ability. Those are very unfortunate who didn't get it. So we can't help in improving these senses. But what's the job of the teacher? The job of the teacher is to draw the common sense from these all five senses. No. The job of the teacher is to draw out what? The common sense of the student from these all senses. Common sense means the child must be civilized. That's the purpose of education. Isn't it? So our job is what? Not to train these senses, but to take out what? Prepare the child for what? With the help of these senses? The common sense. The tongue. Is it voluntary or involuntary? Senses are voluntary and involuntary. So the tongue is voluntary or involuntary? Voluntary. It should be voluntary. Ears? Involuntary. Involuntary. We can do this, but it is nose. Involuntary. So tongue should be voluntary. But andega beta anda. Who said it? And then what had led to? To chupi rati? Right? Jubilha? That time she has spoken like that, and that has led to that great difficulty. Here. So auditory processing, visual processing, sensory. Sensory we have just discussed. Senses. And then socialization. Interpersonal. We have to be interpersonal. Interpersonal is what? We should be good. Hi. Hi. Small talk. Good. Hi. Good. Hey, what happened? Oh. Yesterday I sent her for the substitution. You understand substitution? Substitute period? Or arrangement? You know, she was taking key. I asked, what is your name? Reena. Reena, going 16. 16. Hey, to khali period nahi hai. To 16 is without. This happens? This happens? So this is all about socialization. So there some people have difficulty in socialization. They are not able to, you know, say, be socialized with everyone. Yes. So this is, some people have this auditory processing difficulties. This is not the lacuna. Difficulties. Some is having visual, some is having sensory, some is having socialization. So wherever the person is having difficulty, the other area is strong. Is it? If we close our eyes, what will happen? We will get pressed here. You can listen carefully. Is it? Because we are not able to see. It happens. It happens. So, maybe one place the child is weak, but the other place, to that other place, we have to discover. We have to make that step about each and every child. That where is child is weak. Naturally, if it is weak here, so he is strong here. This is the fact. No one can be weak in everything. No one can be strong in everything. Therefore, these difficulties are not because of vision, hearing. That he is not able to visualize or hear. This is not because of that. This is not because of this autism spectrum which we are going to discuss. There are intellectual difficulties or disabilities. Emotional disabilities, these are not because of this cause. These are somewhere the child, the impression we make. You know, we develop, we teachers develop, the child is weak in this. He is not going to pay attention. So he is not going to pay attention. So the remedy is that we have to serve the matter, the concept, the understanding in a different way. One size doesn't fit all. That you know. One size doesn't fit all. We are all different people sitting over here. If we are 50, so 50 kind of people are sitting over here. Then, this is autism spectrum disorder, Asperger syndrome. These are technical words, but teachers should know. We teachers should know this. This is our field. But whenever we have to talk about, we have to talk about quite gender. Okay? So, go to the next slide, please. See here, autism spectrum disorder. So this is PDD, Pervasive Development Disorder, Asperger Syndrome, Childhood Disintegration or Disability. So you see here, social interaction, communication and behavior. You open this, you have this, it's there. So you read here, I read from here. So this is eye contact, social interaction. Social interaction, the child is not able to see in your eyes. It happens. It happens. When it happens? When the child is something having to hide. Okay? When child is not going to disclose those things. So, eye contact, facial expressions, body posture. Have you seen this all? So, these are the symptoms. When the autism spectrum disorder is there, these are the symptoms. The child doesn't laugh. Child doesn't laugh. Some children, you know, enjoying and say that the child is quiet. But it doesn't mean the child is disabled. If he is sitting alone, so something is going on. So sitting alone doesn't mean the child is disabled, he is not able to get along with the other kids. It means that something is going on, so that we have discovered that he is intelligent in that portion. Are you with me? If the child is showing symptom that he is not getting along with all, sitting alone, kicking. So that is his strength. You don't go to the disability side, you go to the strength side. And prepare your lesson plan according to that, for that particular child. How you have to plan the lesson plan, that we are going to discuss. In verbal communication, verbal, non-verbal. Some are very good at verbal communication. But it happens. It happens. So, they are not good in writing. Then, some are good in non-verbal. You make them write, they write like this. Very good words. Good vocabulary. Sentence structure, really good. But when you ask them to come on the stage, they are not able to speak. Yes, they get paranoid. They get perplexed. So, this is... So, if the child is weak in verbal, it doesn't mean that he is weak in non-verbal also. Maybe, but may not be. So, strength-wise, if we make the child aware of that you are strong in this, बच्चे को कहते ना, अरे यार, आपका इसकी तो बड़े अच्छे हो, तो बच्चे को अंदर लगता है strong है, he feels, ah yes, I'm good at that. Now I will show him what else I can do in this field. And you show him, you are very bad at this. So he says, okay, I'll show you how bad I am. I'll show you. You said I'm bad? अभी देखी तो आज तुमने मेरी. मैं तुम्हें दिखाऊंगा मैं कितना bad हूँ. Yes? So that kind of feelings are there in the kids. So the positive feedback is always fruitful. Then behavior. You know, of course, if the child is having say, some problem here, and we are just talking about problem, instead of the strength, then the behavior will be always like this.